Hello everyone and welcome back to Let's Play Stellaris Federations, the new DLC available right now on Steam and all the other places you like to buy things from on the internet. We have this idle science ship. We don't want idle science ships, do we? We want to survey all that surrounds us. We shall survey. So we shall continue to survey the enemies, well, the systems, and hopefully continue to work towards our habitable planet survey objective. We need 7 more planets to complete this particular goal over here. We've got this bowl colony completion. We need to do this dig site to get that figured out. We've got migrating forests on Jundas Prime. We need to make a decision about which one of these we're going to do. It's going to take a lot of time, though, to sort this out. What's the problem going to cause temporarily, at least? Migrating forests. Okay. Not much at the moment, but we don't really have the sort of scientific power to really deal with that. Like, what, 10,000 research? That's a lot of research at this point in the game. Yeah, everything's kind of slow right now. Yeah. We don't have that sort of research. We have, like, 18 research. It's going to take ages to complete 10,000 points of research. Nonetheless, though, so we have issues over here. Everything's currently costing a lot. We're not massively going to go immediately broke, but something to keep in mind. Okay, so we do have these subspace probes. Alright, where are the probes? We also need to deal with these probes. Alright. Show me the probes. Okay, they actually haven't gone too far. So if we can just enter the system, we should be able to recover these probes fairly easily. So, research that probe, please. There's also one over here. So if you could just hit this system here, and then we'll look at the probe once we get there. But some of these probes may shoot at us, and we'll have to like bring our fleet over to blast the pieces. But we'll see what happens.
Construction complete.
So we have completed construction in this area. So let's get a mining station. Now here is some trade value. So this station could potentially be upgraded to then support. I don't think I have an offshore trade company yet, so we'll have to hold off on that for a little while. Okay, a scanner sweep from the RSX office has revealed one of our sublight probes in the Carjam system, but it seems to have been altered somehow. Modifications of an alien origin have been attached to its hull, and the probe's energy signature is far greater than it should be. We're receiving a transmission from it. You're the monsters? Yes, we made you. No, it's gonna shoot us. Then we shall die. Well, you're gonna flee, so why don't you not be evasive and just leave. There we are. Let's get the fleet. Where is the fleet? Kill this thing, please. Alright. What's our next problem? Everyone's promoting. That's not a problem. Continue. Recovering this probe.
Construction complete.
Alright, we have completed a mining station. That's useful. So we can't get the crystals yet. We don't have the technology, but hey, it's all good. We could continue to snake out to grab some of these other systems. I'm curious about this one here especially. These two are very valuable in terms of resources, so we're okay for the moment, question mark. I'm kind of need to get some administrative offices soon, but this science ship is bored. Are you researching that? Okay. Unrest! The unrest on Citramine is, well, please pause, thank you, has led to mounting calls from the locals for a more pronounced military presence, both on their home planet and within the VitaCorp games as a whole. Okay, well that's fine. Militarist ethics attraction. I'm already militarist. Iron Trail. The RSX Nimjum has picked up a signal from a discarded signal buoy belonging to one of our missing sublight probes in the Urus system. There's an aisle trail leading away from the buoy on a trajectory towards another star, suggesting that someone has towed the probe there for unknown reasons. Let's see where this trail leads. That was in the Ara's system. So it was from here, is it? Let's go back to the situation log. Let's Follow the iron trail, where's that? Let's stop tracking. Okay, so it's still there, question mark? It's still there going, apparently. Let's continue to look around. Because we're covering the probe, so we have here on Satramine some ethics attraction towards militarist. That's okay, I mean... What we can do to increase our stability is to get some more recruits. There's no difference between these. Might as well, just to continue to get some more stability, just get some more soldiers there. Okay. So this colony is doing fine so far. Complete. There's no unemployment. So this probe has been recovered. We have recovered the sublight probe in the Dummum system. The sensor telemetry has collected over the years provided us with a complete survey of all planetary bodies within the system. Okay. Well, that's not really relevant right now, but... This is a tropical world, which is not going to be much use of us right now, but it does have rushing waterfalls and dust caverns, so maybe we'll use our robots to colonize that. Let's continue. There's another one of those probes in here, so let's come over here. We'll then have a look at the anomalies once we've finished with this event chain. So where's our fleet? The fleet is coming along. So you're not doing a thing. Please start surveying again. All right. As our archaeological diggers continue to dig. Azuz, what are you doing over here? Let's read this more carefully. Follow Iron Trail. Let's survey the system, figure out what's going on. Maybe we'll be able to figure it out from there. Our scientist has leveled up, Gayuni. Okay, so we have a dig event. So this is, not sure exactly where this one is, but site summary. Let's see what we've got. So this is our home system. Our archaeological team have started their work on Narfuj. Seismographic readings quickly isolated a hollow area underground on the rough location indicated by the alien indicators previously discovered. The underground expanse is vast, and despite its mysterious nature, one thing is beyond doubt amongst the experts. It's not natural. Someone built it with a specific purpose in mind. Let's keep digging. I'm enjoying the amount of events we've got going in. Natural wormhole. We've detected what appears to be a naturally occurring subspace phenomenon on the edge of the Charna system. A rift in the very fabric of space-time has formed here, creating a wormhole that our scientists speculate may provide a conduit through subspace to another wormhole located somewhere else in our galaxy. Depending on where the second wormhole is located, this could potentially allow ships to travel from one end of the galaxy to the other in a matter of days. Unfortunately, this wormhole, like the vast majority of its kind, is inherently unstable. Any vessels foolish enough to pass through it would be ripped apart in seconds. But if it could somehow be stabilized... A natural wormhole there. Doesn't look like there's any planets, unfortunately, but... Well, nothing habitable planets, but... We'll continue to explore. Our fleet is slowly making their way over. It's going to take roughly a year, but... When does a military ever move quickly, eh? Armies are currently in transport fleets. Okay, so RSX Sialv has detected one of our missing sublight probes in the Yamithir system. We should begin recovery efforts as soon as possible. Yes, indeed. So please research the projects here. So, our archaeological event site has something else going on. So, stability here is still very low, but the soldiers are doing their best to keep things under control. So I think I had two transports here. Yeah, so I'm going to actually get these transports to dock back on the planet once they build. Let's actually look at this archaeological dig site first. So this is the Gunner site over here on Zendrin. Thick layers of ash and a notable mass extinction event in the geological record coincide with material previously extracted from Gunner data crystals, suggesting that the Gunner firebombed Zeldrin 4 with a gelling incendiary roughly 7 million years ago. Widespread deforestation of the planet's surface disrupted local ecosystems, and the lack of oxygen-fixing vegetation gradually depleted the planet's atmosphere over the next 60,000 years. Unfortunate. Let's see what continues to take root. So in 12 days, the next transport ship will be completed. We'll get that landed back onto the planet. So now they're both here, yep, excellent. So I'm not sure if that's going to increase our stability, but it's going to just put my mind at ease at least. If any rebellions do occur, we can have more troops ready to put them down. Okay, so an anomaly was found, presumably in this general area. Over here, probably. Yeah. Let's continue to look around. So the fleet will continue to move forward. Let's recruit an admiral. So fleet upkeep. This guy is a brain slug. Let's go for that, eh? Brain slug, man, go for it. You're unyielding. You got a brain slug. Go for it. There you go. No chance. It's going to take you another 2 months to get there, but we'll see what happens when you do. Okay, let's have a look at this battle. Let's attack that that core. All right, events. The colonial authorities on Jundus Prime reported that one of the local wandering forests has migrated to another region on the planet. Hundreds of thousands of trees have uprooted and marched in unison to this new area, trampling everything in their past. Adds plus 10 devastation. Ugh, peculiar. Alright. Order restored on Satramine. With the significant reduction of crime on Satramine, the moon's once pervasive criminal underworld has been reduced to nothingness. The population's been imbued with a renewed sense of safety and harmony. This is good. So let's have a look at the planet. So we still have this minus 40 stability. It does make me think I need to keep the these soldiers working. But they've got no one in them. No wonder things have been struggling. That should help. Now prioritize the job. Are slaves being soldiers? No, good. Alright. That will make things make a bit more sense. There we go. Helps when they're actually doing the job of being a soldier. Thank you guys. So we probably don't need that job either. At least that's now gonna increase the stability somewhat. But above the danger threshold, at least. But the production here is so much lower because of how much stability there is. So, instability, rather. So, let's continue. Let's have a look at this war. This battle. War is a bit of a strong word.
Reconnaissance completed.
Look at that, our resources have recovered.
Fleet action underway.
Fleet action has begun. As you can see, our small fleet
construction complete
is more than capable of dealing with the alien threat. Little remains of the strange alien modifications that our missing sublight probe have been subjected to, but we did manage to extract some valuable engineering data from the wreckage. Its memory bank was also salvaged, and from it we extracted a survey data of the entire system. Excellent. A little bit of engineering, we'll take that. Okay, well, let's send the three corvettes. It's pretty minuscule navy, let's be honest. Back home. To dock. Thank you. So, this construction ship is currently bored. Please build me some mining stations to get those 2 energy credits. We'd need to consider a trade route in the near future. Okay. Once you've done that,
special
we'll head down here.
Complete.
We've recovered the sublight probe from the Yamatha system. The sensor telemetry is collected over the years to provide us with a complete survey of all planetary bodies which don't exist in the system. Good. That almost knocks out that quest that we had of the sublight exploration probes. Is this the ion trail to go? So we'll see what happens when this survey completes, I guess. So we do have a problem with these forests. There's 5 devastation at the moment, which is what happens normally when planetary bombardment occurs. But it's just going to happen every now and then. There's not much we can really do about it. Nonetheless, though, let's just do what we can. I might, over here, increase the stability of the planet by, so the pops growth speed, just put some planetary growth into it. Yeah. It'll last for 10 years and just move things along a bit. Things are moving a bit slowly. Okay.
Science ship reports enemy contact.
So one of our science ships has also bumped into some further enemies over here. It's unfortunate. So there may be one small route that you can sneak through. Oh dear. We'll continue our exploration. Okay, this science ship, however, is just sitting there lazily, so let's just get it back to work researching these various anomalies that are in the systems. Okay. So we're very slowly losing energy credits, but it's not a big problem for now, but... So we don't have that offworld trade company yet. So I want you to head down here and claim this system. These, both of these systems, frankly, both need to be claimed, but we'll grab this first because it's going to be cheaper. So this ship is currently, almost died, to be honest, but the, it's missing in action. It'll be missing for some time because they had to do an emergency jump to get out. So, archaeological site event pending. Proving grounds. The excavation crew has finally reached the underground structure. Vast angular halls and tunnels were explored. A complete lack of adornment made it difficult to establish the purpose of the structure. When Zafuge entered the main chamber, a deep sound suddenly reverberated. Initially just thundering noise, the sound slowly contorted until an incorporeal voice spoke a single sentence in our language.
Are you ready?
The booming voice was followed by a deep rumble as one of the great walls slowly slid away to reveal a dark corridor. Our archaeologists eagerly went inside. Tread lightly and carry a big gun. Well, the proving grounds is very rich in the nature of our culture, isn't it? Like, we're all about arena battles and stuff. I mean, we sort of had to go through the fire a bit here with this martial law and everything else that's going on over here. We still will hold off on getting more buildings until we get that extra technology. It's just being slowed down by how rubbish everything's been going, but hey. Alien mural. While conducting the surface scans on Yamithir 3A, Science Officer DeVace and the crew of the RSX Silav discover what appears to be an artificially carved slab of rock covered in alien writing. They have not detected any other signs of alien activity on the moon, and exactly how this mural came to be here is a mystery. We have prepared a special project to translate the text. Fascinating. We'll look into that in the future. More anomalies. Anomaly. Left, right, and center. I love it. Keep up the anomalies.
We have claimed a new world.
We have.
Recon pass completed.
We're such world claimers here. So we now have this Tundra world here, which does have access to these special locations. So we don't really want to do too much to it, like messing things up right away. But it's going to be a drain on resources temporarily until we get things started. So, yeah. Zandran Alpha and Zandran Omega will be useful additions to the
Special
Empire.
Special project complete.
Space Amoebas Forever. The Space Amoebas, the name is stuck as the pronunciation of the proper xenotaxonomic denominator, is too unwieldy for the average Tensar. A solitary animals when left to their own devices. All but the younger specimens are accompanied by quasi-independent flagella, organisms spawned by the amoeba and programmed through liquid RNA laced secretions to do the bidding of the host. These flagella are capable of manipulating and even attacking objects in an impressive yet limited range around the host, periodically returning to lodge inside the host amoeba's body for reprogramming. There are potential military implications to be found in the regenerative properties of the amoeba's thick hide or in the flagella's graceful patterns of movement. Okay, so we can choose between two options here. So we've got these flagella are fascinating, or retrieve some tissue samples. So regenerative hull tissue is a curious one, but I believe the more powerful one is actually the flagellating movement, which is a modifier which applies to everything permanently, rather than it being an add-on you have to put on your ship. So we're gonna go for the flagellating movement. There we go. Also our boards are out of bounds science. This guy is still doing nothing. Let's just look around, because we're, I don't know where this thing's supposed to have gone. Who knows? So, next archaeological dig site. So this is the bowl, the Proving Grounds is the one for our homeworlds, but this is the bowl dig site. Several exemplary bowl fossils have been recovered, revealing the long-lost species to have been a hive mind, billions of planetoid units working together as a whole, like the leaves and roots and branches of a tree. Dendrochronology suggests individual bowl specimens had lifespans in the hundreds of years. The lack of structural ruins on Zendron 4 appears to be the result of the bowl's reliance on remarkable organic technology, from ships and buildings to wetware biocomputers and the ravages of time. Fascinating. It does mean the chances of recovering a lot of stuff are slim. But, you know, we'll do what we can, of course. So, alien menace. We need some more firepower before we hit that stuff. Star patterns. The latest sensory readings from Yamithir showed the star pulsating regularly, but when the crew on RSX Sialv arrived on the site, there was no evidence to support this data. While most of the crew in agreement that the anomaly was caused by a sensory malfunction, science officer DeVace discards this theory. DeVace claims to have discovered similar pulsating emission patterns elsewhere, and now fears that something strange is happening to the galaxy stars. They have charted the core to the nearest affected star. Well, let's get to the bottom of this. So, alien mural time there. We'll get him to do these two anomalies, but we've got a lot of things in our situation log. Pulsating stars, alien murals, beta menace, and of course these tree problems. It's gonna take so long though. But nonetheless, though, that is time to call a video. Thank you for watching. When we come back next time, more Stellaris Federations.